Gill slits and embryos. In 1860, there was a man by the name of Ernst Haeckel, and he believed in evolution. He was a German professor at the University of Jena. And during his years of teaching, he tried to convince his students that evolution is true. Now, to prove evolution was true, he came up with an idea that human embryos go through different evolutionary stages as they grow. According to Ernst Haeckel, a human embryo starts out in a one-celled stage, just as its ancient amoeba-like ancestor. And then he said it develops gill slits just like an ancient fish ancestor. And he said it has a tail just like an ancient ape-like ancestor. And therefore, suggested Dr. Haeckel, if we will just watch a human embryo grow, then we'll see the different stages of evolution. He used this phrase, ontogeny recapitulates phylogeny. Now, in order to prove this theory of his, he made several drawings of the different stages of different animals, a dog, a pig, a human, a chicken, a turtle, salamander. But when he published these drawings, other professors started looking at them and saying, Haeckel, where'd you get these? When they started investigating further, it seemed that Dr. Haeckel had not only been inaccurate, but he'd been dishonest. You see, he was proven to be wrong in the 1880s, and his idea about humans going through their evolutionary family tree as embryos, it was shown to be completely false in the 1880s. And that should have been the end of the story, but it's not. In fact, it's not the end of the story at all. Even though Haeckel's false theory and drawings were disproved almost 120 years ago, did you know that they are still being used today in many science books to prove evolution? Why are textbook writers still using these drawings that were faked and altered and falsified? You know, that is the real mystery here. On May 29th, 2010, I was speaking to a group of teenagers in Michigan about Ernst Haeckel and his false evidence, and I explained to them all about the textbook still using these things as evidence. And they said to me, one of them, about 2 weeks after my visit, a ninth grader sent me an email. And here's what that email said. This week in my biology class, we learned about the theory of evolution. During this segment, we had to do worksheets on evolution. Two of the main things we did were on the English peppered moths and similarity in embryos. Those are two things you proved false during your seminar. You taught us that those things were false, but still put in textbooks and taught in schools today. I was both astonished and humored that these two false teachings showed up in my high school the week following your seminar. That's what the ninth grader said. You see, even though Haeckel's ideas were proven false, they're still used to teach evolution today. Why do you think that is? I'll tell you one reason. If you took out everything that we know to be false, that's used as evidence for evolution, you wouldn't have much left to teach evolution. Ernst Haeckel and similarity in embryos, we've known that idea is false for 120 years, and yet the majority of science textbooks still use that as evidence to prove evolution. Well, I'll tell you what that is. That's evidence that doesn't prove anything other than, you know, the theory of evolution is falling on hard times.